Hey, I've got some riddles for you. What's cute, fuzzy, and deadly all over? Okay, how about a fruit fly and a caterpillar walk into a bar, and one of them isn't getting out alive? Or did you hear the one about the caterpillar who dressed like a gummy bear? She looked sweet, but she had a sticky little secret. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
It's me, Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Animalogic. Cannibalism, shape-shifting, and poison? While it might sound like something straight out of Game of Thrones, these caterpillars aren't creatures of myth. In fact, some of these mind-boggling beauties could be right in your own backyard. So let's get into the most fascinating of these lurid larvae. Okay, we all know that wriggly caterpillars eventually grow into beautiful moths and butterflies, but try to remember the story of the ugly duckling, which teaches us that true beauty takes time. While everyone is busy focusing on these guys, they're forgetting about these guys, the unsung heroes, the reason for the butterfly season. They aren't just regal, they're the absolute monarchs of the metamorphosis cycle. Yes, jeepers with creepers. We're talking about caterpillars. The fuzzy, the huge, and the deadly. Due to straight-up pretty privilege, caterpillars haven't had a chance at the spotlight in the same way that their adult form, the butterfly, has. But there is one famous caterpillar in pop culture, and if he's taught us anything, it's that they're hungry. Some may say, very hungry. Right now as we speak, caterpillars are about to take over the tree canopy and start their bulking phase. Spring has sprung, and nature is waking up. Everywhere you look, it's madness. The bugs are buzzing, the birds are singing, and the squirrels are doing squirrely things that are none of my business. Unfortunately, people get a little mad this time of year too. Honking cars, rushing crowds, city noise everywhere. Finding a peaceful spot for nature watching can be pretty hard. Thankfully, I have my Raycons with active noise cancellation to drown out the madness of the city. I listen to music when I draw and put on podcasts when I'm out nature watching. Whether you're watching wildlife, hitting the gym, or grinding at work, these earbuds deliver up to 32 hours of battery life. And thanks to their fast charging technology, just 10 minutes of charging gets you 90 minutes of playtime. They come in a lot of different colors, so you can find the perfect match for your vibes. So, noise cancellation, long battery life, fast charging, and lots of colors. What more could you want from earbuds? Oh, yeah, they're also about half the price of other premium brands with the same features. Beyond all the techie stuff, they have one of the most underrated features, comfort. Thanks to a wide range of gel tips, you get a snug fit that stays put without feeling loose. Get ready for the madness of March by going to buyraycon.com/animalogic20. We'll get 20% off the everyday earbuds. That's right, Raycon is offering 20% off their best-selling everyday earbuds when you go to buyraycon.com/animalogic20. And once you have them, you can go nature watching the weird, hungry, hungry caterpillars. All caterpillars are essentially all stomach, and they have one job, eat. They're basically the Kirby of the bug world. Yeah, these guys inhale food just like the little pink puffball. Almost all caterpillars eat exclusively plants, specifically the leaves of the plants that their eggs were laid on. These plants are called host plants, as they provide both the food and the shelter for the specific species of caterpillar that calls them home. From the moment they hatch, caterpillars don't just grow, they explode in size, packing on up to 10,000 times their original weight before transforming. Their early life is like one long, unstoppable bulk phase. No cutting season, just pure games. And there are a select few who are trying to take their bulk to the next level, rebelling against their leafy fate, swapping salad for straight-up meat, in a full-blown slasher flick twist. So fruit flies, look out, because here comes an assassin that hunts with the precision of a horror movie villain. This is the Hawaiian Eupithecia caterpillar. It's a type of inchworm found in Hawaii. Yep, in case you didn't know, inchworms are caterpillars too. They have the unique trait of being voracious predators, and even delving into caterpillar-on-caterpillar violence. These little hunters can feed on fruit flies, spiders, and even caterpillars when the opportunity arises. They're only about an inch long, but they pack some serious punch. These little hunters hang from their back legs, disappearing as they blend into the sticks and fern leaves, waiting for some poor fruit fly, spider, crickets, or even caterpillar to stroll by. Lined with ultra-sensitive bristles, these caterpillars don't even need to see their prey. The second an unlucky insect brushes past, bam! Anchored by their back legs, they lash out with their six spiky claws, snatching their prey in the ultimate jump scare. The nightmare continues as they slash and tear into their victim, all while it's still alive. Nothing like fresh meat for a growing larva. Because their attacks are triggered by touch, not sight, these skilled hunters can work in the night just as well as the day. Freddy Krueger wishes he had this kind of productivity. Predation is almost unheard of in the caterpillar world, but Hawaii is a unique place. In fact, of all the native plant and animal species on land, 90% of them are endemic, meaning they're found nowhere else on Earth. Scientists believe that due to the lack of natural insect predators, like the praying mantis, there was an abundance of prey. And while other animals saw an idyllic bug world, these hungry caterpillars saw an all-you-can-eat buffet. Classic Mother Nature, always finding new ways to keep things dangerous. Like I said at the top, butterflies have been coasting on their good looks for way too long. But feast your eyes on these absolute icons. They may not have their future wings and elegance yet, but these jewel-toned jelly beans are already serving looks that put their adult selves to shame. This wiggly little gumdrop is the Delceridae moth caterpillar, commonly called the jewel caterpillar. There are around 80 different species in this family. Their sluggy, legless bodies come in an array of opulent colors, from reds, to blues, to greens, to this gorgeous all-white variety. Their most defining feature is the gelatinous bubbles on their back. They may look like candy, but please resist the urge to pop one in your mouth, unless you're cool with a very sticky, regrettable surprise. While they're not venomous or poisonous, like some other caterpillars, they've devised their own unique line of defense. Each of those bubbly orbs on their back is filled with a sticky, oozing substance, an absolute nightmare for any predator that dares take a bite. It's like a mouthful of goo. Other animals, like slugs or certain salamanders, similarly use sticky goo to fend off predators, but you have to admit, the unique bursting bubble of yuck is a pretty special defense. As if that wasn't enough, these gumdrop-like spines can easily detach upon contact. Similar to how some lizards shed their tails when threatened. It just goes to show, in the world of caterpillars, being a wobbly little blob might just be the ultimate survival flex. We managed to get one of these here in the studio, so I'm going to eat it to see how bad it actually is. Ah, thank you. Slimy, yet satisfying. Just kidding, it's Rice Krispies. I've watched enough Bear Grylls to know. In nature, a pop of bright color is often an animal's way of saying, "Don't mess with me, I'm dangerous." Why do you think I'm always putting these bright colors in my hair? Just taking a cue from the best, nature itself. And speaking of natural warning signs, the next little guy uses bright colors in not one, but two ways for the ultimate defense strategy. Meet the Saddleback Caterpillar. He's small, bright, spiky, and absolutely not to be messed with. Found all across the eastern United States, as well as parts of Central America, you can commonly find these guys in your own garden at home. But while you might be tempted by that little brown patch, just begging for a boop, do not do it. If his lime green coloring wasn't enough to give you and any other predator a second thought, this little cowboy packs some serious heat in those spurs. Each horn is lined with venom-filled hairs, and touching them would be a regrettable experience, complete with instant pain, swelling, and nausea. As if that wasn't scary enough, check out this built-in bluff, a fake face to scare off danger. And get this, it's facing backwards. So no matter where you look, this little stinger is sending a warning, stay back. The face also helps confuse potential predators, making it harder for them to target the vulnerable parts of the caterpillar. So it can either scare you or trick you into biting the areas with the most venomous hairs. Pretty smart. Sometimes, though, the most poisonous creatures are more cryptic and well-disguised. This is the Lonomia obliqua, known more commonly as the giant silkworm caterpillar, and he has a venomous sting that is so potent that it can kill you. 5 deaths were reported between 2007 and 2017, but the number could be higher since they live mostly in the Brazilian rainforests. What makes them even deadlier is that they live in large groups, blending into tree bark. Most of the fatal stings happen when humans unknowingly lean their back or hand onto the tree and get a potentially deadly surprise, often not from just one caterpillar, but many at once. Because of increased farming in their native habitat, more farmers are in close contact with them, exposing them to a higher risk of stings. About 400 stings are reported every year, with about 20 of them being considered severe. Lonomia obliqua's venom is stored in tiny sacs at the base of its spines. When these spines puncture human skin, the venom travels through hollow bristles and straight into the bloodstream. Packed with powerful blood thinners, it throws the body's clotting system into chaos and sometimes causes deadly internal bleeding. Without intervention, what seemed like a harmless brush with a caterpillar can turn into a full-blown medical emergency. But it's not all doom and gloom for the giant silkworm caterpillar. Like any great antihero, their powerful weapon can be harnessed for good. Usually meant to kill, it's now also being used to heal. Their venom is being studied to be used as an anticoagulant and helping patients that are affected by blood clots. From rainforest killer to medical thriller, some bugs really do it all. Some of them even try to pull the bluff of the century and pretend to be a snake. This is the Spicebush Swallowtail Caterpillar, another fake-out mask-wearing caterpillar. It has a blotch pattern designed to look like a snake, and it has serpentine moves to scare off potential predators. It even has an organ specifically designed to look like a snake's tongue. Hey there, Caterpie. Since most of their predators are birds, this is the insect version of a scarecrow. It's a display that gives Ka a run for his money. Butterflies may get a lot of attention, but let's not forget that they would be literally nothing without the caterpillars. And while they may not be the classic beauty queens of the insect world, they're fierce, fascinating, and in some cases, downright life-saving. Maybe the real lesson of the ugly duckling isn't just about waiting for beauty to bloom, but about appreciating the weird, wonderful, and wiggly creatures that make the transformation possible. If you liked caterpillars, check out this episode we made about metamorphosis. We get into really weird science, like did you know that caterpillars turn into goo before turning into butterflies? Check it out. And stick around to the end to see some photos of some wild caterpillars that I myself have caught, because I love them.